I'm going to drive this, guys.
Yeah.
Look at the door panels. Look at the ratio of carpet to plastic.
Oh, I've not seen that.
It's nicely cut out.
And it's deeply sculpted.
Yeah.
Now, what they've done is they've used carpet to, A, make it a cheaper build.
But sound, I reckon.
Soundproofing. Yeah. And there's more room.
Do you know, I love the fact that they've mixed up some materials. You've got carpet, you've got leather, you've got this lovely little metal bit.
Yeah.
The roof is a little disappointing.
It doesn't feel great.
It feels like a pub carpet.
It does.
But at least, at least they've tried and they've made an effort. I
mean, look at these headrests, sculpted, beautiful things.
But are they to protect you in the event that you go forward? Because that looks like it's a perfect imprint for your head. Do you reckon?
The infotainment side of the Volvo, you've got this lovely big digital screen. You've got the portrait-style touchscreen, which we've seen a lot of in Teslas.
I love the fact that it's upright. Most cars have theirs like on a horizontal platform.
Yeah.
I just think this is super.
And Volvo certainly hasn't lost their legendary sense of practicality.
You go into the centre console and there's a proper, like, kitchen bin. And you can lift it out. And it's got
a little net!
Practicality!
Why haven't we had, we've seen that many, many years ago. Simple idea, great.
How are things in the back?
Yeah.
Great, we've got a nice little net on the back.
Annette, she's everywhere.
It's just a good place to be.
Yeah.
I reckon you could do a blindfold test and sit in half a dozen cars and you know immediately you're in a Volvo.
Shall we strap up and go?
Yes.
So, does this family runabout also feel refined enough on the move?
So, this bad boy's got a 2-litre petrol.
T4, one of my favourite engines, Johnny.
This is the 8-speed auto. It's really smooth. The thing about it is, I think they've got the damping and they've got the sort of chassis just right, because you never buy a Volvo for a sort of hardcore chassis.
No.
And it's got a number of things on it, like the sunroof option, 360-degree camera. Some of the options are really useful, but they are options, so you've got to be careful. Volvo is a little bit stingy with stuff as standard. And one thing I noticed when I first got in it, and you guys might find it in the back, that your posture's really nice.
That car on the drive was an absolute pleasure to be in. I'm going to be bold here.
Go for it.
For the price point of this car,
yeah,
this is the nicest interior I've ever sat in.
Ever?
Yes.
Wowza.
For the price point.
Cool.
So, what's the scores on the doors for the stylish Swedish-designed SUV?
This is a Volvo I'd recommend to a mate, so I'm going to give it a cracking 8.
I really like lots of things about this car, so I'm going to give it a 9. Or as they say in Sweden, meow.
I think it's great. I'm going to score it probably the highest score ever. It's a 9.
It's a great car, and it's a great all-round car, and I really like it, and that's why I'm going to give it this mark. An 8.5.
Which gives the Volvo XC40 a very impressive team test score of 34.5 out of 40. Bra gjort! That's well done in Swedish, in case you're wondering.
Today, engineering obsessive Jimmy DeVille is looking at a modern motoring icon to find out just what made it so special and changed our motoring world.
You don't have to look very far these days to see one of those. They are literally everywhere. They're fast, they're comfortable, they're luxurious, and most importantly of all, they're safe.
Yes, I'm talking about cars with four-wheel drive. This S3, for example, like most Audis and many other performance cars, puts down its considerable grunt through all four wheels. It improves safety, handling, and performance, and is a technological feature we all take completely for granted these days.
But there was a time when a four-wheel drive road-going car like this was unthinkable.
Unthinkable because the engineering challenges were so great. Nobody could figure out how to get the power to all four wheels without creating so much extra weight that the performance and handling were ruined. Nobody, that is, until a group of Audi engineers in the 80s came up with this. This is the legendary Audi Quattro, a modern motoring icon that changed the world of rallying and was the first proper performance four-wheel drive car for the road.
Obviously, this car has none of the modern-day creature comforts you'd expect of an Audi. It certainly doesn't have swooshing indicators and headlights that look around corners, but I tell you what, it feels good.
This Quattro was the brainchild of a clever bodder Audi called Jörg Benzinger.
Jorg was winter testing a military vehicle called a VW Iltis.
The Iltis was a small Jeep designed for the German military. Small, light, and with four-wheel drive, it could go just about anywhere.
Its performance was completely untouchable.
Jorg saw the future and realised that if he could come up with a compact, efficient, four-wheel drive system, it could offer previously unheard of capabilities and performance in a road car.
It really did take a massive effort from Audi because they had to redesign almost the whole drivetrain. So how did the Audi team do it?
Let me explain how Audi's innovation changed the modern performance car forever.
OK, this is a standard two-wheel drive, rear-wheel drive car. What you have is an engine, that's it there, which spins a gearbox, and out the back of that comes a prop shaft, which goes to a differential. This allows the power to go in two directions, left and right, to your rear wheels. They're both driven. And at the front, you then have two wheels that will do the turning but aren't driven.
The problem with two-wheel drive, as demonstrated here, is that it can be hard to put the power down effectively.
Now, if you need more traction, what you need is four-wheel drive.
The challenge for the Audi's engineers was how to get drive to the front wheels as well, without adding the weight of a cumbersome mechanical process.
This is where the magic happened. And as an engineer, I can't help but be in awe of this. It looks simple, but it really is genius.
Audi's breakthrough idea was to put a second differential inside the gearbox and then a hollow shaft to take drive to the front. The system was light, compact and efficient, and performance driving would never be the same again.
It took a few years to get this idea into production, but when it did, it changed the car world forever.
When the rules changed to allow four-wheel drive cars to compete, the Audi Quattro dominated the ultra-competitive Group B rallies. Because it had more traction and performed better on loose surfaces and in wet and snowy conditions. Just 3 years after the Quattro was released, all World Rally Championship cars became four-wheel drive.
So the next time you're driving your modern-day car and you're wafting around corners, not thinking about differentials or any of that, spare a thought for Jorg and his team at Audi for making your life much, much better.